We're here behind the scenes talking with Kristina Wayborn, also known as Magda from Octopussy. We know a lot of that past, and then we jump over to today, and we have a gap in there. So where have you been and what have you been doing?
So I've had a few years of difficulties. My husband passed away, my mother and my father passed away, and I have been fighting breast cancer. So I'm just on the other side of that and feeling stronger and better than ever. And I wanted to rise out of the ashes a little bit. You know, I really like the fact that I can now be an inspiration to other women because of everything that I've been through. You know, the illnesses and the difficulties that we all have to face sooner or later in life. And the fact that there's more life on the other side of a very traumatic time in your life, I think is something that we can strengthen younger women with, and older alike. And I'd like to be an inspiration to other women for many reasons. I feel very fortunate to have been able to play Greta Garbo, one of our main film stars from Sweden.
You
know,
did a fabulous job.
Well,
that.
Thank you
that
very much.
Amazing.
The segment that I did was called The Silent Lovers. It was about Garbo's love affair with John Gilbert. And then, of course, Octopussy was a fantastic opportunity on a commercial level. It was just unbelievable to be able to work with those people there.
If this was this character, what would that kind of look like to you?
I have no idea, but I have a little bit of an idea that she would be general in the Russian army, maybe.
Oh.
She is very powerful. But she's very, very, very under the radar because she has learned you have to be very quiet sometimes. And then you can rise and make point, and then you have to withdraw and go back to roots to get strength. I am very linguistic, as
yes,
you know.
Yes, I read
I
that
speak
too,
several but... languages. I do a Russian accent. I do a German accent. We speak Swedish with a little accent, of course,
yeah.
Because we are from Sweden. We grew up on an island in the Baltic Sea. It's a testament to the franchise itself that a Bond girl that was there for so many years ago can come back and still be a Bond girl. I think that carries a lot of PR. You know, for other women to see, you know, you can really do this.
You were Bond girl, basically, now you're back, you're, you know,
yeah.
And nothing has changed.
I'm trying to keep it off, but it takes a lot of exercise these days. It was sort of a free gift from above before, you know, but once you get to a certain age, you have to work at it.
But if you do, these are the results that you can get.
And I think also, you know, comparisons between so many years ago and today, you know, technically speaking, movies have come a long way. But, you know, Octopussy still stands there, and it's a wonderful work of art.
So it's a very elite club of women that have been, you know, chosen and honored in that role.
True, but there are a lot of women that deserve to be Bond girls, that will never be Bond girls.
Right.
And those are the women that I want to reach. Those are the women that are out there, they're wonderful, beautiful, strong women that have gone through similar things to what I've gone through. And I want to inspire them because we're all Bond girls at heart, you know. We are mysterious, we are strong. We have more than most men do in a New York Minute.
And we
so,
are Swedish, and we are Russian, and we are
and
German.
And we are also French, of course. We cannot forget the French.
And you've gone on, you've matured, you've conquered. So
yeah.
Now you are, you know, you carry that emblem on your hat very well, that now you
And
have.
You may call me General.